Nothing is permanent. Everything in the universe is in a constant state of motion, and the forms they assume are way stations. The moment you look away, they acquire other dimensions. In reality, no one ought to know anybody. I just woke up. I have a sore throat and I feel strange. And yet I must find the strength to get up. I have one more day here, and I must make the most of it. What a strange sensation. Without the weight of gravity, the body feels no fatigue. My joints are loose. I feel as light as a feather. I feel good inside my clothes. Yet I no longer look at myself in the mirror. There is no vanity. Sometimes I remember the bars, the people socializing, like children full of innocence. They know so little of the grandeur they are living. I like spending long hours at home, resting, daydreaming. I liked writing a little each day. I loved the cinema. The films became a part of me forever. I'm fascinated by nature, the waters, becoming one with the landscape. A scent, a footpath, a sound are enough to make me feel total freedom. Today, I will see my father. I will sit beside him, embrace him, feel him. It will be like it used to be. I wonder, is he still sad? Now I am flying high, very high above. I am a seagull, spanning my wings over the sea, few and far between, a slash in the sky. I feel the need to gaze at the horizon. Earth, sky, the perfect balance to make you dream. I know a corner where there is no light. You can see the stars and the moon. When I was sad, that's where I used to go and cry. But now I won't cry. Tomorrow, I am going back. My name is Liliana. My luck changed suddenly and without warning. I died when I was 24 years old. was born and raised in Buenos Aires. I met Pedro when I went to our farm. I would go almost every other day. We became a couple. I loved horses. He suggested we go skiing, and without a second thought, I said yes. We left in the morning. Our first trip together. I was so happy. The next day, we drove towards the mountains. When we got there, it was so beautiful and strange. There was an eerie silence. We reached the hotel in the afternoon. It was very cold and windy. The sky was dark and menacing. I went to bed and I thought how perfect my life was going to be. In my sleep, I heard a deafening noise. I woke up terrified. At dawn, there was the avalanche, and we died in each other's arms. When I felt the last breath leaving my body, a strange emotion went through me. I felt my senses gradually leaving me, beginning from my arms and legs, and continuing to the rest of my body. I tried to hang on to my thought and consciousness, although by now I started feeling dizzy and afraid. When all my senses left my body, I found satisfaction in that I still remembered who I am and where I am. But as time passed by, even that was difficult to hold on to. It went away quickly, and all that was left now was a feeling of love and warmth from the memories of the life I had lived. In the end, these memories too begin to fade. And now the fear grows because you feel that you no longer have anything connecting you to what you were. You feel that you were something, but you don't know what. You feel that you are now something indefinable, an entity unknown to you. For 3 months after the moment I passed away, my soul went and nestled inside my father. The journey begins through the person who loves us most on earth. It gives him strength and courage for the loss, and at the same time prepares the soul for the next stage, that of the ascent. When the energy, which my soul had, left my father's body, it found itself in a big, absolutely quiet and dark void. I felt no fear or curiosity or alarm. It was simply a very calm moment of tranquility and silence. I felt myself floating in a friendly environment, a familiar void. I had been here before. Gradually, I began to move and to see a bright blue light following me. But in the end, this light was emerging from me. As the speed with which I moved grew, I began to see other lights moving in the void around me. The black void had filled with many lights that floated round and round, but always towards a central direction. It is a unique spectacle. I had already found myself in another magical and totally different environment. I had no body. I felt that I was no longer Liliana, but I was aware of what was going on. I could see with my soul. I could understand without my senses. Then I learned that every 3 years for 3 days, I would be able to visit with my previous life, see my parents and my friends and how they were getting on with their lives. But they would never know about it, nor would I be able to change something for them and their lives. I also learned that while the body I had on Earth had been lost, my brain had not suffered the same fate. The brain becomes part of the global brain, where all the brains of humankind that have ever existed on Earth are collected. This gigantic mechanism of knowledge and experiences on the one hand receives, and on the other gives to each new birth on Earth. So when we're born, we all have a part of the global brain. Here is the field of genius. Many brains which are special and extraordinary. They have preserved their status almost intact. The field of genius, a large empty meadow where interesting and unique meetings take place of all the extraordinary brains that have ever existed on Earth throughout the ages. Perhaps Aristotle, Einstein, Copernicus, and Nietzsche are having a lively philosophical debate, while Le Corbusier and Oscar Niemeyer, along with Leonardo da Vinci and Isidorus, talk about perfection and beauty. Finally, I realize that I can choose the father, mother, or children I want to have in my next life. I can choose the role I want to play in my next life. I will continue to collect experiences. I will take on a role I've never had until now. Until I obtain all the experiences, I will make this journey 900 times.